was Thanksgiving Day, but now I realize that today is the day of evaluation and feedback, thanks to Artem. So please raise hands those of you who are coming here to improve his or her public speaking skills. Don't be shy, please. And now please raise hands those of you who are coming here to improve the experienced people skills, or also improve the speaking skills of young speakers. Not so many people, right?
To help you?
Yes, to help. So most of us come here just to improve their own skills. That's why Mrs. Toastmasters, ladies and gentlemen, today I want to talk about importance of evaluation and feedback. So we will talk about importance of receiving feedbacks, like from your fellow Toastmasters, how should we do it, why should we do it. The second thing will be the benefits of providing evaluation. I think that it's not important just here, it is also should be important with your relatives, friends, or even colleagues. And after all, we will have some practice part. So let's continue. So I really believe there are two ways, two kind of people. First, So first people, there are two ways to get things done. First way, you go on the road and you're like learning on your own mistakes. You don't listen to other people's. If someone criticizes you, you like don't put it, and you don't listen to them. Like, and I have to say that I am that kind of person. So stubborn and yelling, unwilling to listen to other people's advice. So I have to admit it. And the second way is the way when people learn from another people's advices. So if you want to follow this way, you should go through next tips. First one is be thoughtful. So ask for clarification of any points from evaluator's verbal feedback, because for a while, if you think about it, you will understand that you will know. That some comments become clear and more helpful. And secondly, be engaged. You should listen your evaluator very in a proper way. So you should give him all your time to your evaluator. For example, when Artem will give evaluation to me, I will listen to him very openly. The third way, be positive. It means that if someone criticizes you, you should take it not like on your own self. You should think that it will just help you. The other thing is that you should be open. It means that you should take evaluation and feedback without objectives, and you can ask any questions after evaluation, after the speech. Okay, let's continue. Benefits of providing evaluations. So our votings show that a lot of people want to learn more and they come here to improve their skills. But maybe only one person or none of us wants to, how to say, to help other people to learn more, for example, right? So, I think that giving evaluation is very important too, and I also agree with Artem. So it can help not only here, it can also help you to build relationships with your, can you go back a little? It can also help you to build relationships with your relatives, help you with your friends, and also with your colleagues. For example, for women, can you go back? Sorry? Yes, so one of the most embarrassing thing is when men throw their socks around the flat, right? So I think that right evaluation could help in this situation. So if the woman will give right evaluation to her boyfriend or husband, you can escape this problem. Second one. Second thing happens when your wife, for example, a girlfriend, doesn't cook well. So there are two things you can say. You can say it's awful, or probably you can say that the other things, but if you will give her proper evaluation, she begins to cook well and you will be happy. And the third way, if you have any problems with your boss, for example, or with your colleagues, you should give them right evaluations and it will stop. So I want to give you some advices how to succeed in this business, right? So let's continue. Stay positive. It means that studies show that positive feedbacks leads how to say positive feedbacks. Sorry, can I use it? It's been a while. Great likelihood of achieving goals. So you should seek a balance between positive feedbacks and negative feedbacks. If you give too much negative feedbacks, the person will not listen to you very openly. Yes, and there is one method called sandwich feedback techniques. First of all, you should give something good in word phrase. For example, if I were evaluator of Artyom, I would say that he's a very charismatic person and he gives a right speech. Then I would like say like a little criticism, like he's doing the same speech at the same time, yes. And I think that, and the other thing, that he is so good that he could do it much better next time, maybe with other speech. Okay? Then be constructive. It means that constructivism. Okay, thanks. So you should point some special areas, not about the whole speech, but some part of the speech. And it will help you also. One-on-one evaluation. For example, it means that after speech or after some situation, for example, when your husband throws the socks, you should come to him and you should talk with him about this situation. If you will talk with him about it, maybe in 1 month later, he will forget about it, right?
He will use this.
Yes. He will throw the new socks, maybe in you. And limitless. So you should limit your feedback into 1 or 2 points, probably 3 points. If you give too many negative feedbacks, like the person will do it again and again, and he will be angry on you. So let's continue. We have some practice here, and you know, guys, I think that Toastmasters, like we should give our feedback everybody, not just evaluator, but everybody. So you should open. We'll continue. You should open Telegram chat, find ATC official announcement, you should choose new agenda, you should open my name, just my name, and please give me your evaluation feedback, thank you, and remember about these steps, okay, next, stay positive, be constructive, limitless, and I will be thoughtful, engaged, and positive, thank you for your feedback.